हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर योगेश पावड़े, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बायोकेमिस्ट्री एंड सेंट जेस मेडिकल कॉलेज एंड KEM हॉस्पिटल मुंबई। इन दिस पर्टिकुलर सेशन टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट केस बेस्ड क्वांटिटेटिव एस्टिमेशन ऑफ सीरम क्रिएटिनिन एंड यूरिन क्रिएटिनिन एंड वी आर गोइंग टू डू कैलकुलेशन ऑफ क्रिएटिनिन क्लियरेंस रेट। एक्चुअली सीरम क्रिएटिनिन एंड यूरिन क्रिएटिनिन एस्टिमेशन, दीज आर इंडिविजुअल प्रैक्टिकल्स, separate practicals, and these exercises will be kept for question 1, that is quantitative estimation in your examination. So you may get serum creatinine or urine creatinine alone, okay, and when there is urine creatinine, you get calculation of creatinine clearance rate also in the particular exercise, provided you get daily urine output for that particular patient or clinical case scenario. And in this particular case-based quantitative estimation, the quantitative estimation will be based on the clinical scenario given to you in examination. A particular case will be given to you and you will be asked certain questions like give probable diagnosis, some investigation might have been given to you and you will be asked about further investigations. And when the diagnosis and the investigations are okay, then you can go for the you can perform that particular test on the given sample, given unknown sample, okay. So we'll go for serum creatinine and urine creatinine. So what is the case? This is a clinical case for that particular practical of quantitative estimation of serum creatinine and urine creatinine. So what is the case? How does it state? A 46-year-old woman presents to the emergency department with a 2-day history of right-sided loin pain and macroscopic hematuria. The pain is continuous and dull in character. She was noted to be mildly hypertensive during her 3 pregnancies. She has no other significant medical history. She neither smokes nor drinks alcohol. On examination, she is febrile. Her BP was 160/110 millimeters of mercury. CVS and RS were unremarkable. On palpation of her abdomen, bilateral masses are palpable in each flank. The right-sided mass is tender to palpate. And 3 investigations are given to you. Results of investigation are given to you, like serum sodium, it is 138. Millimoles per liter, that is within the normal reference range. Serum potassium, 4.3 millimoles per liter, that is also in the normal reference range. So these 2 investigations are not deranged. Serum urea is 95 milligrams per dL, which is higher. So the questions are, what is the probable diagnosis? Which other laboratory investigations would you do to confirm the diagnosis? Perform those laboratory investigations with appropriate method. Okay, so now we are going to answer this and we will see what are the key factors in this particular clinical case given to you, based on which you are going to identify the probable diagnosis. Okay, and you will be answering the subsequent, you will be answering the further questions based on the clinical case and the probable diagnosis which you decide. So what are the key points in the case history? Patient's age and sex, that is 46-year-old woman, right-sided, continuous, dull, aching loin pain. So probably in the area where there are kidneys and excretory system. Macroscopic hematuria, again if there is any injury or any obstruction in excretory system or maybe in renal pelvis, you will get hematuria kind of kind of symptom. Then patient is found to be hypertensive, so hypertension also causes renal damage. Bilateral, bilateral, tender, palpable masses, maybe because of hydronephrosis due to post-renal obstruction and increased blood urea levels, okay. So that also suggests there is some element of renal failure because of which blood urea nitrogen is increased. So the probable diagnosis is acute renal failure due to obstructive uropathy. Okay, because of some stone, maybe at the level of bladder, maybe ureter, maybe urethra, because of which there is obstructive uropathy causing hydronephrosis and leading to renal failure. So you have got a probable diagnosis. You have got few investigations as well, which include blood urea nitrogen, which is increased. Now, what are the further investigations you will be doing? So these are additional laboratory tests which you will be doing on the given unknown sample here in this case, particular case scenario. So these are serum creatinine, urine creatinine, creatinine clearance test, and urinary stone analysis can be done if stone is found after the surgery. Okay, so there are many tests which can be done in this particular clinical case scenario, but for the scope of our session, we will be limiting ourselves to these tests only. So serum creatinine, urine creatinine, and creatinine clearance test. So the quantitative estimation will be of serum creatinine and urine creatinine, but creatinine clearance rate will be just calculation based on the values of serum creatinine and urine creatinine and when urine output is given to you. The method for serum creatinine and urine creatinine is same, that is modified Jaffe's method. So now the session is divided into three parts: serum creatinine, urine creatinine estimation, and creatinine clearance rate. Now we'll go one by one. We'll go for serum creatinine first. So estimation of serum creatinine by modified Jaffe's method. So you know, for the quantitative estimation, we always have a protocol or a format of writing your answer for this kind of practical exercise. So we'll write principle first. What does it state? Let me read it for you. Proteins are precipitated from serum using tungstic acid. Creatinine present in protein-free filtrate reacts with alkaline picrate solution to form an orange-colored complex of creatinine picrate, the intensity of which is measured colorimetrically at 530 nanometers. A standard creatinine solution is treated similarly and the color intensities are compared. Now, if we understand the principle, it is stated that proteins are precipitated from serum using tungstic acid. So before creatinine in the unknown sample reacts with alkaline picrate, the proteins are to be precipitated from serum, okay, using tungstic acid. Why? What is the need of precipitating proteins? Because if proteins are there, the proteins will react with alkaline picrate and will get precipitated and it will make the solution turbid. Okay, so if we have intended to measure optical density because of the orange color developed due to creatinine picrate, we will be measuring the optical density or the absorbance which is contributed by the turbidity caused due to protein precipitation. So to avoid the falsely high creatinine levels, we have to get rid of the proteins from the serum sample before it before the creatinine in that particular sample reacts with alkaline picrate solution. Okay, so what are the reagents required? That is sodium tungstate 10%, sulfuric acid 2/3 normal H2SO4 sulfuric acid. Now these two reagents are used for precipitation of protein, and remaining three like saturated picric acid NaOH 10% and standard creatinine solution of concentration 0.003 milligram per ml. So these are the reagents required, and we are discussing like alkaline picrate solution. So alkaline picrate is prepared by mixing 10 ml of saturated picric acid with 2 ml of 10% NaOH, and these are the reagents required for the practical. Now, first part of the practical, that is process, first of all, the procedure of the practical, that is preparation of protein 3 filtrate. What is the procedure? We have to make a mixture first. So, in that, we will be adding 7 ml of distilled water, 1 ml of blood, 1 ml of 10% sodium tungstate, and 1 ml of 2/3 normal H2SO4. So, mix the content properly. Keep it for 5 minutes and then filter, so that proteins will be precipitated and then you will filter the solution. So now the total volume of this particular mixture is 10 ml and we have used 1 ml of blood or serum. Okay, so effectively we are using 0.1 ml of serum per ml of protein free filtrate. Remember this, because this value we will need in the calculation part. Second part, that is color development or actual reaction between alkaline picrate and creatinine in the unknown sample. So like all other quantitative estimations, here also we will be taking 3 test tubes, we will labeling them blank, standard and unknown. And this is how we are going to do additions. So, okay, see, we are going to add 2.5 ml of alkaline picrate in all 3 test tubes. And we add 5 ml of distilled water, creatinine standard and protein free filtrate respectively in blank, standard and unknown. We mix the content properly and keep it at room temperature for 15 minutes so that complete reaction will occur between alkaline picrate and creatinine, so that creatinine picrate is formed, which has orange color, and the color is red colorimetrically at 530 nanometers or against green filter. Now here look at this particular point, that we have used 5 ml of protein free filtrate. Okay, and what we have seen in the previous slide is we used, what is the actual volume used of serum? It was 0.1. It was 0.1 ml of serum per ml of protein free filtrate. So here we used 0.1 into 5, that is 0.5 ml of serum we have used actually. Okay, so this figure will need in calculations. This is the format of observation OD table and doing calculation. Okay, so you'll be writing optical densities getting after the practical. Okay, so blank, standard and unknown optical densities, and this is a formula. This is a common formula for almost all the quantitative estimations except estimation of enzyme activities. Okay, so what is it? OD of unknown minus OD of blank divided OD of standard minus OD of blank into concentration of standard in units of mg per ml. So this unit is of the standard solution given to us, multiplied by volume of standard in units of ml into, because we need unit per deciliter, we will be multiplying it with 100, so that it is 100 milligram, sorry, it will be per, because it is per ml, so it will be per 100 ml, so per deciliter will be the unit. And volume of serum, here the actual volume of serum which we have used in the unknown tube. So here it will be 0.5. It will be 0.5 ml of serum which we have used in unknown tube. So actual volume of serum used. Okay, we have just discussed how this 0.5 value has come. Rest of the values are given to you in your reagent required and during the addition procedure. Serum, and you get the multiplication factor is 3. So OD ratio multiplied by 3 will give you serum creatinine value. So for this particular session, I had performed the practical. I did the estimation of serum creatinine and urine creatinine on the samples. So these are the optical densities which I have got, and you can note down these values and put in your journal till you join back and perform the practicals in person. Okay, so these values after putting in the formula I got this value 2.14 milligram per deciliter. Okay, this is the serum creatinine value of the same patient. Now we got serum creatinine 2.14. What is the normal reference range? There should be something against which we'll be comparing our results. So that is normal reference range. It is 0.6 to 1.2 milligram per deciliter. Okay, so our value stands beyond the normal reference range, beyond the upper limit of normal reference range, right? So what are the causes in which you see increased serum creatinine levels? Yeah, in cases of urinary tract obstruction, chronic nephritis, renal failures, may be acute, may be chronic, right? And acromegaly, gigantism, early stages of muscular dystrophy. So to explain these causes of serum creatinine, I'll give you a general concept that for any analyte or a parameter, it has a normal reference range in serum or plasma. Now if it is normally present and the levels are maintained, or the parameter is maintaining its level, normal reference range, in serum or plasma, that means there is something source, there is something like source of that particular analyte. That analyte may be excreted or degraded or metabolized in the body. So the addition to that normal reference range and deletion or subtraction because of its degradation or excretion or metabolism of that particular analyte maintains the normal reference range. So what is the source of creatinine here? So creatinine is a metabolite of creatine, a normal constituent of muscle. You know that creatine phosphate is there, which provides you second line energy for the muscular activity. Okay, it replenishes ATP from ADP. So level of serum creatinine does not depend on diet, because it depends only on creatine. It is excreted by kidneys, and hence its estimation is done to assess the kidney function. Okay, so this is what creatinine is and the levels. And you know, serum creatinine levels may be decreased in case of muscular atrophies. Okay, so because the source, if there is, if muscular inflammation is there, muscle inflammation is there, myopathies are there, dystrophy, muscular dystrophy is there, because of which the muscle mass will be extensively lysed, and it will result in increased serum creatinine values. Or on the contrary, if its excretion is decreased because of renal failure or any other renal pathology, because of obstruction or something like that, excretion will not happen, the serum creatinine will be retained in serum, thereby increasing serum creatinine levels. Okay, so now moving on to the second part, that is estimation of urine creatinine by modified Jaffe's method. So for this particular estimation or the analyte, we get urine sample. Okay, so the principle, I'll read it for you. It states, diluted urine is treated with alkaline picrate solution to form an orange colored complex of creatinine picrate, the intensity of which is measured colorimetrically at 530 nanometers. A standard creatinine solution is treated similarly, and the color intensities are compared. The color intensity is directly proportional to the concentration of creatinine. Now here, if you compare, though the method is same, method is modified Jaffe's method, both for serum creatinine and urine creatinine. Okay, but what is the difference? In case of serum creatinine estimation, we prepared protein free filtrate, and here we dilute the urine sample given. Why do we dilute it? Because urine has a large amount of creatinine, okay, because it is excreted beyond the linearity of the modified Jaffe's method. Now what is linearity and why do we dilute it? If we do creatinine estimation in undiluted urine, what will happen? Because of high level of creatinine, the value will be beyond 8 milligram per deciliter. If it is more than that, you can't be sure whether it is 9, 10, 11 or 15, because that is a point beyond which you will get plateau phase of optical density, plateau optical density. So you will see, yeah, the creatinine level is very high, but optical density is not increasing. Okay, so in that case, you don't know whether it is 8, 9, 10, right? So it will be difficult to manage. In that case, what you do is, you dilute the sample with appropriate dilution factor. Okay, you bring that high level of creatinine well within the range of linearity, well below the range of linearity of the particular method, and you estimate that, and with the by multiplying with the dilution factor which you have used, you multiply the result and get the actual value. Okay, so that the creatinine level in a given diluted sample should be below 8 milligram per deciliter, that is the linearity of modified Zeffis method, and you get the authentic and valid estimation of urine creatinine. Okay, hope you understood that. So what are the reagents required? That is picric acid, once again, although the concentrations and molarity normalities are little different. Picric acid is 0.4 normal, NaOH is 0.75 normal. Now coming to the procedure. Yeah, first part of the practical, that is dilution of urine. Here we dilute urine 100 times with distilled water, but to dilute we have to be very careful, because if we are going to take only 1 ml of urine sample, we have to use it, we have to, you know, take that sample with the help of micropipette. If you can see here, this micropipette is used to dispense 1 ml of urine sample in this flask. Okay, and we add distilled water, because we have added 1 ml, so we will be adding 99 approximately to make it 100, so that it will be 100 times diluted. So on this particular flask, the neck of the flask, you will see a marking here, you will see a marking here, and we go on adding distilled water so that we reach this mark. So don't count to add 99 ml, because eventually that will be 99 ml added, 99 ml of distilled water added, but we have to follow and you know, reach this mark with intermittent mixing urine with the added distilled water. Okay, so you may choose to add 90 ml first, and remaining 5 you will be adding with the help of some pipette or some calibrated instrument, so that you do not overshoot this mark. Okay, so this was dilution of urine. Coming to the second part of practical, here just like urine creatinine, just like serum creatinine, you will be taking 3 test tubes, labeling them blank, standard and unknown, and these are the additions here. Now we do not prepare alkaline picrate here, we will be adding alkali, that is 0.75 normal NaOH, and picric acid 1 ml each in all 3 test tubes, and we'll add distilled water, creatinine standard, and diluted urine, okay, 3 ml each in respectively in blank, standard and unknown. Okay, same procedure, mix properly, keep at room temperature for 15 minutes, read colorimetrically at 530 nanometers or against green filter. Okay, you see color developed here, color is developed here. Okay, this orange color is of creatinine picrate, this is the blank which has only alkaline picrate. Coming to the format of observation and calculation, it is the same, only difference here is 1 by 100, we are multiplying here this particular value by 1 by 1000. Okay, we are multiplying it 1 by 1000. Okay, now the unit required is gram per liter, so we are multiplying with 1000. Okay, so that we get, because the unit of concentration of standard is milligram per ml, so to convert into gram we will multiply with we will multiply the value with 1000. Now I want unit per liter, so these mls I will be dividing with 1000 so that I will get per liter. Okay, so 1000 cancelled and you will get a multiplication factor of 1. So OD ratio multiplied by 1 will give you urine creatinine in units of gram per liter. So after doing a practical on urine creatinine, I got these values, I got these optical densities for blank standard unknown, and after putting these values I got urine creatinine 0.7 gram per liter. This was a result based on the sample which you received. Okay, the sample of urine which you received. Okay, now I want to calculate urinary excretion of creatinine. Okay, this is standalone. This particular reading is a standalone reading on the basis of the sample which you received, right? But now I want to calculate urinary excretion of creatinine per 24 hours. So what will I need? I'll need this value and I'll multiply it with total urine output in a day or in 24 hours. Okay, so this value multiplied by volume of urine in liters will give you urine creatinine excretion in grams per 24 hours. Now we got 0.7 grams per liter, and here the normal reference range is given per 24 hours. Okay, grams per 24 hours. So we need to have total urine output of that patient so that we can calculate urine creatinine excretion and compare with this normal reference range. So I did that in calculation of creatinine clearance, but I'll tell you I have taken urine output of that patient as 1 liter. Okay, so the reading will be 0.7 to 1.5. It will be 0.7 here for the patient. It will be, if 0.7 multiplied by 1 liter will give you 0.7 grams per 24 hour, that is the urine excretion in that particular patient, and which is below the normal reference range quoted for urine creatinine excretion. Okay, so that means kidney is not filtering creatinine properly and it is not excreted. So what are the causes for high urine creatinine levels? High urine creatinine levels means acromegaly, gigantism, diabetes mellitus, infections, where the source of creatinine, that is muscle, has undergone some pathology or there is some inflammation, because of which urine creatinine levels are, it will increase serum creatinine first, and that serum creatinine will be excreted, and so urine creatinine levels will also be increased in cases of muscular dystrophies or myopathies, initial stages. Okay, low urine creatinine levels are observed in paralysis, muscle atrophy and advanced renal diseases. So after or in the later stages of muscular dystrophy, you will see the atrophy. When the muscle mass is completely atrophied, there will be no muscle mass which will be continuously pouring in creatinine in the circulation, because there is no muscle mass when the muscle is atrophied. So because of that serum creatinine levels will also be decreased, and it will reflect in the same way in urinary excretion of creatinine as well. Okay, and if there is renal failure, creatinine excretion will be decreased in urine, and you will find decreased urine creatinine excretion. So might be that is the case in this particular patient. That's why the value we got is 0.7 gram per 24 hours. Now after estimating serum creatinine and urine creatinine, we have values of serum creatinine and urine creatinine, and we have taken urine output or total urine output in a day as 1 liter in this particular patient. So now we can go for creatinine clearance rate. So, first of all, what is the reason for choosing creatinine for clearance test. Creatinine is a waste product. We know that it is formed from creatine phosphate by spontaneous and non-enzymatic conversion. So it is continuously occurring in the body. It depends on total muscle mass of the body. It is not affected by diet, age or exercise. As you know, blood urea nitrogen is affected by diet. So it is not the case with creatinine. So it is quite stable compared to blood urea nitrogen. About 98% of creatine pool is in muscle. So we can ignore 2% of creatine pool, which is in the other tissues, okay? Because 98% is in the muscle, and about 1.6% is converted to creatinine per day. So continuously, 1.6% out of that 98% is continuously converted into creatinine. So creatinine is filtered at glomerulus and is neither reabsorbed nor secreted by the renal tubules. So in health, there is no reabsorption of creatinine, there is no tubular secretion of creatinine, it is only filtered at glomerulus. But when serum creatinine levels are very high, in that case what happens? There will be tubular secretion of creatinine as well. Okay, so that is the disadvantage. We'll discuss about that. Since the production is continuous, the blood levels will not fluctuate much. So there are reasons for fluctuation of serum creatinine level is the muscle mass and the pathology related to muscle mass or pathology related to excretion by kidney, right? So in those condition it will affect, otherwise it will not affect, because there is continuous conversion of creatine phosphate to creatinine. It is an ideal endogenous substance for clearance test. We don't have to do anything for its conversion. It is spontaneous, non-enzymatic. Hence, the creatinine clearance can be estimated to measure glomerular filtration rate, that is GFR. Okay, this is the reason why we choose creatinine to assess kidney function test, to assess kidney function. Okay. So, theoretically, what is creatinine clearance? So by definition, creatinine clearance is defined as the quantity of blood or plasma. It is the quantity of blood or plasma which is completely cleared of creatinine in unit time or per unit time. Okay, so this is the definition. And clearance, we don't quantitate creatinine, we quantitate plasma or blood which gets completely cleared of creatinine in unit time or per minute or per second, like that. Here we do per minute. The formula for creatinine clearance is UV by P, where U is urine creatinine in units of milligram per deciliter. U is in units of milligram per deciliter. And what we got? We got gram per liter. In our result, we got gram per liter. Okay, so we have to convert the unit. P is plasma creatinine. Unit is milligram per deciliter. And that is the same as that of serum creatinine. So there is no need to change here for serum creatinine or plasma creatinine. Then what is V? It is the rate of urine flow in units of ml per minute. So this rate of urine flow we have to calculate based on the total urine output given to us. We have taken urine output as 1 liter here, and we know serum creatinine value and urine creatinine value from the previous two practicals. Okay, so after putting the value 0.7 for U, that is urine creatinine, 2.14 for serum creatinine or plasma creatinine, and here the total urine output is 1000 divided by, we have to calculate per minute, so 60 minutes into 24 hours, so 1440. So the calculation here comes out to be 22.72 ml per minute. This is the creatinine clearance in the given patient. Okay, Now, to compare this and interpret, we have to have some normal reference ranges. This patient was female, and what is the normal reference range for female is 75 to 115 ml per minute. But for males, it is slightly higher on both sides, lower side, lower level and higher level of the range. It is 85 to 125. Why these levels are different for male and female? Because of the muscle mass, which you know contribute to the serum creatinine levels. In males, the muscle mass is more, so the urinary excretion is also more, and that's why the creatinine clearance is also higher side in case of males compared to females. But remember, this creatinine clearance is uncorrected. Okay, because here we are not actually considering the muscle mass, we are not considering the height. Okay, these parameters we are body surface area, these parameters we are not considering here, and those should be considered. Okay, but in your examination, when creatinine clearance rate is asked, you will be using this formula UV by P, because body surface area will not be provided in the clinical case. Okay, so you have to perform, you have to calculate creatinine clearance with this formula only, that is UV by P. Now, what are the advantages of creatinine clearance rate? We have discussed, but in details now we will think about that. Is if creatinine clearance rate is to be used as a GFR marker, so what are the advantages? The conversion of creatine phosphate to creatinine is spontaneous, non-enzymatic, so it is effortless. We don't need any effort or intervention to produce or to, you know, to administer this particular parameter for assessing kidney function. So it is endogenously produced. As the production is continuous, the blood level will not fluctuate. Blood may be collected at any point of time. Okay, extrarenal factor will rarely interfere. It is not affected by diet and exercise, this is very sure, as it is the case with blood urea. Coming to disadvantages of creatinine clearance rate as a GFR marker. Now, that tubular component or tubular secretion of creatinine is actually a disadvantage of using this particular clearance rate as a GFR marker. Now, let us see what are the factors of the total excretion. About 10% is by tubular secretion. When the GFR is reduced, GFR is reduced means what? Glomerular filtration is reduced. The secretion component will be automatically increased, and that will affect the results. The creatinine clearance is said to overestimate GFR by about 10 to 20 ml per minute. Why? Because of this 10% value of tubular secretion. The GFR is severely reduced, extrarenal excretion increases. When GFR is severely reduced, the creatinine will be excreted into intestine. So the extrarenal excretion will increase. So if that creatinine is secreted in intestine, the bacterial flora in the intestine will degrade it, and that will be the major route in such case. So the level of serum creatinine will be decreased because of degradation of creatinine by intestinal bacteria when it will be secreted in the intestine. So now kidney is not the only source or only factor which decreases serum creatinine levels by excretion. It is also the small intestine, is also the intestinal flora which decreases creatinine. But when GFR is reduced, okay, yeah, very early stages of decrease in GFR may not be identified by creatinine clearance. That is called as creatinine blind area, because we are overestimating GFR by 10 to 20 ml per minute. So this will be the creatinine blind area, because we overestimate means even if we are touching the normal reference, lower side of the normal reference range, we might have overestimated GFR, and we are वी टेंड टू इग्नोर द केस ऑफ रीनल फेलियर और डिक्रीज इन क्रिएटिनिन क्लियरेंस रेट, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज क्रिएटिनिन ब्लाइंड एरिया. अदर पनल रीनल एंड पोस्ट रीनल कॉजेज विल इन्फ्लुएंस क्रिएटिनिन क्लियरेंस. ओके, सो एज द ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन ऑफ एक्सक्रेटरी सिस्टम बिकॉज ऑफ एनी स्टोन, इफ दैट इज इंक्रीजिंग ब्लड यूरिन नाइट्रोजन, दैट विल ऑल्सो इंक्रीज सीरम क्रिएटिनिन. ओके, सो दिस पोस्ट रीनल रीनल एंड प्री रीनल कॉजेज विल इन्फ्लुएंस क्रिएटिनिन क्लियरेंस एज वेल. कमिंग टू करेक्टेड क्रिएटिनिन क्लियरेंस रेट, एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड द प्रीवियस फॉर्मूला डू नॉट यूज बॉडी सरफेस एरिया, सो वी नीड टू गिव करेक्शन विथ बॉडी सरफेस एरिया. सो बिकॉज इन केस ऑफ चिल्ड्रेन एंड पर्सन विथ शॉर्ट और टॉल यू नो स्टेचर और फिगर, सो वॉट विल हैपन, इंक्रीज मसल मास इवन इन केस ऑफ टॉल फीमेल, यू नो दैट विल बी अ कन्फाउंडिंग फैक्टर. सो वी हैव टू गिव करेक्शन बेस्ड ऑन द बॉडी सर्फेस एरिया. दैट इज ए, द फॉर्मूला विल बी यू वी इंटू 1.73 डिवाइडेड बाई पी, दैट इज प्लाज्मा क्रिएटिनिन, इंटू टोटल बॉडी सर्फेस एरिया. And the unit will be ml per minute per 1.73 square meters. Okay, so this will be the unit formula, and this is the corrected creatinine clearance rate. When corrected for surface area, the creatinine clearance value will become comparable between male and females and children. So the normal reference range now need not be separate for female and male. Okay, so it will be a you know uniform normal reference range when the creatinine clearance rate is corrected. So what is that? It is about 100 ml per minute per 1.73 square meters. Now let us give a thought how to differentiate between renal failure and muscle disorders based on serum creatinine and urine creatinine levels. Okay, so in case of renal failure, if you see, serum creatinine is going to be increased in both the cases. Okay, although serum creatinine in case of muscle disorder is increased initial phases only and decreased in later stages. Okay, and what happens with urine creatinine? It will be decreased in renal failure because creatinine is not excreted. In case of muscle disorder, it will correlate with the serum creatinine levels. So when muscle dystrophy starts, initially the serum creatinine level will be high, so urine creatinine levels will also be high, and when it will decrease, when there is no muscle mass left for degradation, so the serum creatinine will decrease and it will lead to decrease in urine creatinine levels as well. So what is the creatinine clearance then? It will be obviously decrease in case of renal failure, but it is not affected in case of muscle disorders because serum creatinine and urine creatinine values are changing in proportion. So the creatinine clearance will not affect much in case of muscle disorders. Okay, so this particular session we have discussed case based quantitative estimation of serum creatinine as well as urine creatinine. So I'll again reiterate the same thing, these two practicals are individual practicals. Just because the method of estimation is same, and it will be very good if you understand both the parameters together, because the reasons for their increase, their decrease, okay, and their interlinked you know fluctuations are there. So that's why it is pertinent to study serum creatinine and urine creatinine together, and after that we have calculated creatinine clearance rate and we have studied its factors, or I mean advantages factors, which make it best endogenous marker for assessing kidney function. Okay, so thank you so much for listening to the presentation, and you'll get the assignment which needs to be submitted to ensure your attendance, and that assignment will be easy. That is the sole purpose of the assignment, is to ensure your attendance. For any queries, you can write me on Telegram or you can mail me for the clarifications of any doubts if you have. Thank you so much.